Good afternoon, Bradley here. Today's video, I am participating in a series going around the vinyl community, and it's about the Blue Note 4000 series. So this was thought of by three members of the VC, Sherv at Julius Jabbar, Dave at localbandography, and Rob at Sound Strange. So this is my contribution. So today's album I will be talking about is, if you can hear in the background, that is Stanley Turrentine. The name of the album is Comin Your Way. This was recorded in 1961. But it was not released until much later, and I will get to that after I show you some photographs there. Okay, so the actual catalog number on this is, it's 4065, right up there in the corner. And like I said, this was recorded in 1961, but it was not first released until the late 70s. And I am thinking, I may not be correct in this, but I'm thinking that first release was a Japanese release. And then in the late 80s, there was an American release of this album. I think it was combined into a 2-for-1 deal by Blue Note. And I think on both of those albums, it was actually called Jubilee Shout. And if you notice by the, it does have the catalog number. So that's the original catalog number. I watch The Jazz Shepherd by Daniel. And he has a show every day. And I did ask him, I asked, why do some of these releases that were never first released until the late 70s or 80s, why do some of them have the original catalog numbers and others do not? And he said that actually, most of those delayed releases never gave them original catalog numbers. But this is one of the few that they actually did. And actually, Reed Miles at the time, he designed that record cover. So they had everything ready to go, but they just did not release it. And I will tell you the members of the band on here, if you can see them right there. Of course, we've got Stanley Turrentine on tenor sax. On trumpet is Stanley's older brother by 6 years, Tommy Turrentine. Now on piano, you've got Horace Parlin. On bass, George Tucker. And drums, Al Harewood. Right there. So, The rhythm section on here, the piano, bass, and drums, that was actually the Horace Parlin Trio. They grew up, Stanley and Tommy grew up in Pittsburgh. And one of Stanley's friends in high school that he ran around with, and I'm sure he played music with, was Horace Parlin. So on this album, you've got a very tight rhythm section who knows each other, and you have a pair of brothers who I'm sure know each other very well. So on this album, you know, it's a very tight sounding. And it's beautiful. getting back to Stanley, probably shortly after this was recorded, he married the Hammond B3 organist, Shirley Scott. And they were married throughout the 60s. And they played on each other's albums. He played on hers, she played on his. Put a lot of stuff out. So with this group here, I mean, very tight group. Now, like I said, this was recorded in 1960. This was Stanley's third Blue Note album. The first was on Blue Note, I think in 60 maybe, was, what was it, Turn Around? I think Turn Around was the name of it. That is an excellent, excellent album. Super. Or no, it wasn't Turn Around. It was called Lookout. Lookout. Lookout, Turn Around, whatever. Sorry for that. And then his second Blue Note album, he was kind of like co-headline with The Three Sounds. And I have seen somebody review that on this Blue Note series. So, very cool. And also, in the 60s, or 1960, Stanley made a pair of albums with Jimmy Smith, Midnight Special, and Back at the Chicken Shack, which were recorded at the same time, but Chicken Shack was not really released until 3 years later. But they were recorded at the same session. What I'm getting at is that Stanley Turrentine and Jimmy Smith, they had a lifelong kind of like collaboration. They would play on each other's albums. Stanley would play on a lot of Jimmy Smith's albums for the rest of his life. So, okay, that's probably enough background information. Let's get on to the songs. Okay, on here you have seven songs, which when you glance at the titles on the back, you're thinking, oh, there's seven songs. No, that first song just has a long title. It should have been indented. My Girl Is Just Enough, Woman For Me. That was the song that was playing before this particular one in the background. So that song, it's got Stanley's nice, deep, full-toned tenor sax. And in fact, that's why Alfred Lion liked Stanley so much. He liked that bluesy, bluesy, soulful sound that Stanley could get from his saxophone. So on My Girl's Just Enough, Woman For Me, his brother Tommy Turrentine has a beautiful solo on there. And if I were to describe Stanley's sound, if you're familiar with Hank Mobley, okay, and you may or may not be familiar with Ike Quebec had a gorgeous lower register tenor sax that was perfect for ballads, as is Stanley. But Stanley could also do a little more of the, you know, going towards Hank Mobley. Okay, the second song on here is Then I'll Be Tired of You. And almost all of these are standards. Not well-known standards, but they are standards. And that's the song that's playing right here, Then I'll Be Tired of You. Beautiful ballad. Now the last song on the first side is called Find Lil Lass. Did you understand me? Fine, F-I-N-E, Lil, as in little, Lass. Not refined little ass. Oh well. That's a hard bop song. Sounds fantastic. Okay, flip the album over. On the B side, you start out with the only song that was written by a member of this quintet, which is called Thomasville. That was written by Tommy Turrentine. It's hard bop. Of course, it centers on Tommy Turrentine as I'm watching a Amish buggy roll by. Clip-clop. Very good song. Sounds great. So the second song on the second side is Someone to Watch Over Me. That's a Gershwin Brothers ballad. Beautiful ballad. Stanley could play ballads really good. Now the last song is a song that was written by Wild Bill Davis called Stolen Sweets. Very upbeat song. It's probably my favorite song on here, although this whole album is really good. It's good stuff. It really is. So in wrapping this up, I'd just like to say I'm glad that Sherv and Rob and Dave got this thing rolling, you know. This will be great for future viewers on YouTube. It'll be a nice archive and a wealth of information concerning this 4000 series of Blue Note. You know, if anybody wants to learn a little bit about one of these Blue Note albums, all they got to do is turn on the video. And I know Sherv was talking about maybe he'll think of some way to kind of subdivide these videos up, because I'm not sure how many records there are on this series. There's a heck of a lot. So that might be a good idea. I don't know. But that's up to them. So anyhow, that's it for today. Once again, Stanley Turrentine, Comin Your Way. Okay, that's all I have to say today. Everybody have a good one. See ya.